this morning became aware of Buddha mind. It's right here. And I said, okay, Holy Spirit, shatter all the remaining resistance in one, you know, swoop of your sword, just whoo. And instead of some cataclysmic shattering of something, the Holy Spirit told me something and said, look at everything that you want me to, the sword to cut away. Okay, look at everything. I said, yeah. I said, and the Holy Spirit said, do you know that nothing at all is rooted in endlessness? There's nothing rooted in it. It's rootless. Everything that you see that appears to be rooted in it is not. You cannot have anything rooted in it. And I said, really? You mean like that tree that's there with all the roots that going out around the trunk and the roots, and then you mean that they're not going down into endlessness, not rooted in that? No. It's only sitting on top of it, as it were, and you're just assuming that it's rooted. So illusion has no roots in truth at all. Illusion has no roots, actually. The conflict of light has no roots in light, actually, because it's not a conflict. Mirage is not actually rooted. Let us say you're on a desert plain, salt lake, and dry salt lake, flat, and you see this mirage of this vast forest. You say, wow. And then you want the mirage to go away, let's say, but you say, wow, I'm going to have to chop down that entire forest. How do I pull out all the roots? How do I get rid of the roots? Is it so rooted in? It's not rooted in it at all. A mirage is not rooted in reality. There's no roots. So that is the sword cutting everything. The sword that cuts everything, all the roots, is the realization that there are no roots. And this is just gradually dawning on me. You know, I wasn't like shaken up by it. I just said, huh, that's interesting. I had a massive amount of realizations this morning, and I need them. I need to, you know, it's do or die time for me. And this just happened to be the one that I had never thought of before. Nothing needs to be cut. There are no knots. Nothing needs to be undone. So this is just a complete turnaround. You know, it's all this time I've been cutting down these trees, these blockages. Saying, how am I going to get this tree out? The huge stumps, you know, a forest of stumps, cutting all down. And now I realize that the forest was never rooted in the ground at all. The end has no roots in endlessness. Time has no roots in timelessness. It's not rooted in it. It's nowhere. Uselessness is not rooted in usefulness. It doesn't need to be uprooted. Nothing needs to be uprooted. So we've been going at this gradually, thinking, how am I going to uproot this? And now the realization is, it don't need to uproot it. It was never rooted. Now, why did we go about it in such a bizarre way? Think we could have this answer all along? Because continuity fear. leave here. We were not ready to realize, oh, there's nothing I need to do. There's nothing I need to do at all. And we're not ready for that. So we say, no, I've got to diminish. I've got to insights. I have to go through all this stuff. That's just the way it is. Because of the continuity fear, there's nothing you can do about it except to keep making progress every day until you get to the point where you realize you never needed to make any progress at all. And intellectually it seems, well, why don't you just do that first? Because continuity fear. We're so used to effort and trying and progress and filibustering and judging and measuring and denying and struggling and all this. We wouldn't know what to do with ourselves if we didn't have all of that. So Buddha mind was here. It's here. And of course the world doesn't want it to be here. They say, we want you to continue to be useless or used to uselessness. The world wants to shatter silence. They want a teacher there. They want a vocal coach. How do we learn to shatter the absolute stillness of endlessness, of Buddha mind, of one seamless block of all is universal being? How do we shatter that? Well, so they come to you and, coach, how do you shatter that? And there is no coach there anymore. There's just the Buddha mind. They say, where's the coach? Vanished, without a trace, don't know. Well, we want to be coached. We want to be coached how to shatter the stillness. How do we shatter the stillness? No coach. No coach here. Gone. Uselessness gone. See, I've been entirely useless my whole life because that's what people want. They want uselessness. Futility here. A Buddha mind is very useful. Christ mind, Buddha mind, one mind, vision of oneness is very useful. But the world wants uselessness. Most do. So there's just a massive amount of clarifications and realizations this morning. But it's not enough. Not enough. Now, it seems like it's never enough. But what the Holy Spirit seems to be telling me is that you don't need any help because nothing is rooted. The complete rootlessness. No such thing as rootedness. So we don't need help to be who we are. We just think we need help to get rid of what we're not. But what we're not is not rooted anywhere. What we are isn't rooted anywhere. We're entirely rootless. So, I experienced the Buddha mind for a moment this morning and said, ah, that's great. Usefulness is here. Now, if that would end the cycle of uselessness, and there's a tremendous push to get me to be useless my whole life, and it's coming up very soon, if I don't accept usefulness, my life's going to be useless my entire life. There's a deadline here. So I have to, break the chain, or realize there is no chain to break. There never was any chain. That breaks the chain. There never was any chain. Very soon. Reach a point in your life where you're either going to continue on the rest of your life as useless, or you're going to decide to be useful. So I was going through all the objections and dismissing them, but who knows, how it's going to play out. So I'm just giving it a try. That's all. The guru asked you, what are you here for? I'd say, well, what am I not here for? Really? What am I not here for? What have you come here for to learn? Say, what have I not come here for? That's the answer. We might say, well, I have this problem. What's the problem, Guru? As well as, nothing is rooted. This is all useless. Well, Well, the answer is on the tip of my tongue. It's just the continuity fear is you know, on the brakes a little bit. It's like Budamine was here this morning. Okay, you know, tap the brakes a little bit. Okay. So that's part of it. That's probably the most important part of it is how do you respond when you lose, you know, when you lose what you really want, when it slips through your fingers because of the continuity fear. Try as you might, it doesn't come back, right? It doesn't come back. We're looking for the roots of it. Where are the roots of this? There are no roots. If reality has no roots, how do you root anything in it? Is the question. You cannot. The rootless cannot be a medium for roots to grow in. So just ask the Holy Spirit what's next. Sometimes we forget, we're so struggling with the situation, we forget to ask the Holy Spirit what's next. What's next? Well, this is what the Holy Spirit told me this morning. I said, what spiritual practice? And it said, Father, Mother, Sister, Brother, what a joke, there is no other. Father, Mother, Sister, Brother, what a joke, there is no other. Father, Mother, Sister, Brother, what a joke, there is no other. Father, Mother, Sister, Brother, what a joke. There is no other. There's no father, there's no mother, there's no sister, there's no brother. What a joke. There is no other. There is no otherness. There's no definition. Therefore, there's no words. Words without definitions are meaningless. There's no definition to everywhere. Because to define something, you have to have something else. In other words, it's this and not this. Definitions are always dualistic. So there cannot be a definition of everywhereness, what is boundless. You say, it's the one. Understanding, we don't mean one as opposed to not one. We mean all there is, without a second. So you can use words, but it's up to the listener to either accept than the non-dual connotation of it or not. It's just a non-dual pointer. It's a pointer. So, what I'm saying is there are no roots to cut. The root cutter is too heavy. It's dragging us down. This effort to cut the roots. We're sinking. The world is sinking. We're going underwater. And here we are trying to cut, using this heavy root cutter, this heavy ability to cut through the roots. Okay. What we have to do is abandon that effort at some point. and realize there aren't any roots to cut. There aren't any roots to cut. Now, this is a tough one to enunciate and to talk about. Intuitively, I can see it, but talking about it, I can feel frustration. I just have to remain calm. See, Buddha mind is not cutting roots. It's not engaging in insight. It's not engaging in the spiritual path. It's not engaging in effort. It's just present. So there's no roots to cut. There are no lies rooted in truth at all. There are no lies rooted in truth. Every lie seems to rest upon truth, giving the impression of roots, but there are no roots, actually. It's the impression, it's a... When we look at trees, they're looking at a tree there, we assume, well, this tree trunk goes down into the ground and is rooted, but what if the tree trunk was just resting, it was cut flat, it was flat, and it's just resting on the ground there, and the tree is just balanced, it's not falling over, somehow it's just an appearance that's there, and there's no roots at all, it's just looking like. And we just assume it's growing from the roots, it's not. It's not at all. What if everything was just not rooted at all? It's all this growth, it's just an appearance, it's a mirage. Like. So I'm just letting this, I'm just considering this. That's what I was given. Father, mother, sister, brother, what a joke. There is no other. There is no other. There is no other. There is no otherness. Nothing is rooted. There is no otherness. Again, light is faking the whole thing. It's all a fake. I need Buddha mind today, 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 not tomorrow, today. And I'm thinking, how in the world can I cut all those roots in one day? Too many roots are still there. There's still too many trees of blocking me. It seems like impossible, but there are no roots to any of it. There's nothing rooted in conflict. There's nothing rooted in conflict. Conflict is a fake. Light is not in conflict with itself. We get filibustered here. The world, people say, just wait, I have something to say. Just wait, I have something to say. Just wait, I have something to say. Just wait. And they keep doing this their whole lives. And you'd say, well, wait a minute. No, just wait. I have something to say. I haven't said it yet. Just wait. I have something to say. Just wait. All they do their entire life is just wait. I have something to say. Just wait, I have something to say. They don't have anything to say. Just wait is what they're saying. Just wait. In other words, just be useless. Which is, of course, denying reality. Just wait for the light. Just wait. Reality doesn't wait on anything. How could it? Light is instantaneous. So it's saying just wait is, it's spiritual ambition. Now, when we say be patient, it's different. That's because of the continuity problem. Because we are so used to waiting, we're afraid of immediacy. So the belief that everything, lies are rooted in truth, we say, well, it's going to take a long time to pull those lies out. And now the Holy Spirit told me there are no roots at all, which means it doesn't take any time at all. So patience is different. That's a virtue. Filibustering is not a virtue. That's what the world does. They want to filibuster, and they'll say, "Wait a minute! I'm asking you a question. I want to hear the answer to the question. I want you to hear the answer to the question. Just wait. I'm still talking. I want to hear the answer." They want to keep an uninterrupted filibuster going. Saying, just wait. That's their continuity fear that's in control of them. See, the whole path is to be in control of the continuity fear, be managing it. Has to be intelligent management of it. That's the whole point. That's why you have virtues of repentance, humility, listening, quietness, understanding how the continuity fear reacts, the backlash, progress to backlash. So you have times to make progress, times to be quiet, let the backlash, this is intelligent management of the continuity fear is the spiritual path. And those who do not acknowledge the continuity fear and being controlled by it are just saying, well, just wait. Hey, wait, don't say anything yet. I haven't said what I want. Just wait. And they'll just do that their whole lives. And of course, they're indignant if you say, hey, go beyond words here. We're here to go beyond words. Just be quiet. No, wait. I haven't said what I want to say. So just wait. Just wait. Just wait is what they want to say. That is what they are saying it constantly. That's what words are doing. Words are just saying, just wait. The essential word is wait. So we're so used to waiting, we're afraid of complete non-waiting. Buddha mind, presence, pure presence, vision of oneness, we're afraid of that. So we do intelligent waiting. We're looking at the waiting, say, is that really necessary? Is that really necessary? I don't think that's really necessary to keep waiting. Let's just be quiet. Seamless presence. Nothing needs to be said. No definitions. Is there seamless? Just seamless. Waiting is implying that there's something not yet here. In other words, just wait. It means something's coming. It's almost here. Just wait. Right? So that is a statement of a denial of the presence of now. Just wait. That's time, isn't it? And space also, because something is coming from where? In space. Time, space. Just wait. Just wait is time, space. It's saying it's not here now. Just wait, it's not here now. Right? Just wait means it's not here now. What is not here now? Everywhereness is here now. So saying it's not here now means there's something other than everywhereness. Father, mother, sister, brother, what a joke, there is no other. Father, mother, sister, brother, what a joke, there is no other. I asked the Holy Spirit, but what is the fastest way right now? So it said, Father, mother, sister, brother, what a joke, there is no other. That certainly has resulted in experience, the emergence of the Buddha mind, as they call it. It's a good term, isn't it? It's just Buddha mind. Father, mother, sister, brother, what a joke, there is no other. Father, mother, sister, brother, what a joke, there is no other. There is no otherness. In the quiet of meditation, you can get to great understanding, and then when you go out in the world, there's this tacit social contract that interferes. And so I feel all this resistance. Say is, hey, the Buddha mind can't be here, not now, you have to wait for it, and if you don't, we'll have to shatter it, And they'll say, well, we'll shatter it sooner rather than later if you don't back off. So it's really, a threat. Or we'll shatter it even worse if you don't back off. Say, well, you are so shattered, meaning we are going to shatter you so severely. We're going to lay a curse upon you, such a severe curse. We're going to curse you, but now we're going to curse you way more severely. Now, there's this heavy, and the demand is to not go beyond words. That's the demand, actually. The demand is to not go beyond words. That's the demand. And those who do, the world rushes in and says, oh, we need to take over this situation. We need to take it over. So we're here to take it over and reestablish words. We've got to make sure that the presence of silence is not here. Got to fill it up with words. Is to thank them for that. Thank you for attempting to take this over. And appreciate very much the strong show of opposition, resistance. That's great. Very great. Okay. Now you can go. Resist not evil. Love your enemy. Remember this, we have to do this. The ones that come and say, wait, that's just the light. That's not spirit. That's the play of light saying, there is no silence. We can't have silence. Silence is forbidden. We must stop this. This will cause you to realize you're not God. We can't have that. And so it has to put up a fight against it. So, because we ask light to show us that we were God. So light is lying to us. And what light says, hey, if you allow this silence to be there, you'll realize that, you're not the prime creator. You cannot uncreate this. You are the created. You're one with all is one, but you're not the prime creator. You cannot separate from that. You cannot be greater than that. There's no way. You cannot be greater than the prime creator. Cannot be greater. So the light is insisting that silence not be here. It's like you train a dog to bite you. And you say, bite, and it bites you. Then you start hitting the dog and you say, ow, that hurts, you know, stop, it tears your dog. All you're training is to tell the dog to bite you and to hold on, don't let go, like a pit bull. So the dog bites you, doesn't let go. And you're blaming the dog? No, say, thank you, dog. You're perfect. You did exactly what I asked you to do. Thank you so much for that bite. Okay, now my request is that you let go of the bite. You see, you have to be like that. So thank you for the filibuster. It's exactly what I requested. Thank you for the demands that I be useless. Thank you very much for that. I appreciate it so much. Thank you for your refusal to accept my appreciation. That too is greatly appreciated. If you're not rooted, you can't be uprooted, right? I mean, if reality is rootless, how can we be uprooted from it? Father, mother, sister, brother. What a joke, there is no other. Very powerful mantra. Father, mother, sister, brother. There is, what a joke. There is no other. There is no other. So as I said, the Holy Spirit suggests, say, thank you, light, for your resistance, opposition to this. We're only going to do this for a little while, just a little test out for a little while. Then we'll reconsider your opposition. Perhaps we'll reconsider opposition then. So don't say, Buddha mind forever. Say, well, Buddha mind for a while. For a short while, and maybe we'll reconsider at that point whether to reinstall uselessness. So let's be useful for a little while, useful for a little while, and then perhaps we'll reconsider whether we want to continue with, go back to uselessness or not. This lifts the continuity fear off. So we have to be intelligent. Usefulness, I'll be useful for a little while, and then we'll revisit the objections and resistance and call for to return to uselessness. Maybe we'll revisit in a while. Possible, sure. Doors open to that, but I'm going to give a little while to get used to this, so we're going to not entertain opposition at this time. But maybe a little later is possible. This is the way. This is the way. I'm feeling of the fear, you know, huge constellation of fear lift off. This is the way. And now, of course, the light tries to trick us and say, hey, don't you want to be a great teacher? Don't you want to be known as a Buddha? What are you talking about? You need to make a declaration. You need to say, I am the Buddha mind. This is the Buddha mind. It is here. It is here forever. It is, you know, what are you talking about? You're going to try to test it out. little bit for a while, just a little while. I'm not going to make any big declarations or anyone. What are you talking about? That's where's your courage? Where's your, you know, light tries to trick you that way. And say, no, actually, this is my courage. This is honoring my courage and my fearlessness. Because saying that I have this continuity problem, saying that you all have a continuity problem too, is honoring you. Because that means you were so fearless, you were so courageous, so resolute, that you tried to change reality and you kept on trying to insist that you can do it for such a long, so much, that you have now this severe continuity problem. So, I would say the best teachers are the ones that are not really claiming to be teachers, actually. Or, I say, well, you know, I'm just hanging out here. Don't really say, like, big, strong declarations, like, here I am the greatest. I am here to save you, you know, and all these huge declarations. No, the best teachers, just saying, someone say, are you a teacher? I don't know, maybe. Maybe for a little while, we'll see. Never know, we'll just see how it goes. And maybe for a little while I can, you know, do a little of the function that way, but maybe later we'll have to revisit it and like that. Downplay it. Ramana Maharshi downplayed, didn't say anything, did he? Hey Ramana, are you a great realized Yanni? Just quiet. Where's all your teaching? Just quiet. If you're a teacher, where's your teaching? Where are your books? Just quiet. I don't know, maybe. Maybe some people might see me that way for a little while. Well, for a little while, I'll let a few people, you know, look at it that way. But maybe later, well, we'll see. We'll revisit it. Nana my ma never said she was a guru or a teacher. She said, well, I'm just a silly little girl, she would say. I'm just some silly, mentally retarded person, really. Don't mind me. Don't mind me. Why do people come to see you? She said, I don't know. They like to come see me for some reason. I don't know why. They ask me questions, and if something occurs for me to say, I'll say it. But if not, I don't. I can't always respond properly because I'm stupid. That's how she was. I'm. You know, how can I respond properly to everybody? I don't know how to respond properly. I'm uneducated, stupid. Some people call me teacher or guru or whatever. I don't. They want to do that. Yeah. I have no objection that they want. That's how they want to see it. I can't always please them. Can't always please. I'm not able to please everybody for some reason. I don't know why. I'm just really kind of stupid. That's just a problem that I have. It's like that. It's the opposite of the ones that say, hey everybody, I'm here, I'm God, I'm here to you too. You're so fortunate because now I'm here for you and I'm going to lift all of you out of this situation pronto. And I can't fail because I'm God, I'm the ultimate guru, all gurus are subject to me. Everything is subject to me, I will simply cause everything to happen for you. Don't worry, I'm here, just worship me, you know. I am forever the greatest, forever, you know, all this stuff, you know. Ah. best gurus. Don't you really need to say they're gurus? Don't really need to say they're teachers. People would try to insist, and not in my mind. I have this great guru. She's my guru. He says, No. I'm not anybody's guru. I'm not a guru. I'm not anybody's guru. What are you talking about? Well, somewhat. Well, I want to look at it that way, but you know, I'm not going to say, you know, no to them if they, you know, I'm just whatever. Everything's fine. Everything's fine. Everything is equally fine with me. Everything's perfect. What is there to teach? Everything's perfect. What's the fix? Everything's perfect. How can you be a guru? There's no fixing going on. There's nothing happening. So this is the smart way, the intelligent way to go about it because of the continuity problem. Continuity problem is massive. It is severe. People want to set you up so they can tear you down. They want definition so they can attack the definition. They want to talk. They want to define. They want to judge. They want to stay away from the silence. The absolute stillness. Where there is no definition. What else can we do when we want to be greater than God than to insist that definitions are reality? There isn't oneness. There is separateness. The continuity fear is so severe that... the answer is just allow Buddha mind to be there, be aware of it, and just let it be there. Let it be there. That's all. For a while. Say, okay, Buddha mind. So, the rapid way to make progress is to take this approach. And we keep forgetting about it. I keep forgetting about it. Because we're spiritually ambitious. So we want to help. Of course, we have good intentions. But good intentions here have to be supremely diplomatic. Otherwise, the wheels will come off. It doesn't work. Very diplomatic. So, Buddha mind comes. See, what you do is you say, Buddha mind, I'd like to invite you here, your presence here, for a little while. Now we think Buddha mind will be insulted. Like, what do you mean? I'm the greatest. This is reality. This is what you really want. How dare you invite me here for only a little while? Like that. You think your friend will be insulted. So we keep working on, how can I get them here totally, so that's just totally, they can teach and heal everybody and, you know, free everybody. Well, there's no healing or freeing up necessary. We're already free. There's no sickness. It's all an illusion. So how do we go from it's all an illusion, thinking it's real, to it's all an illusion? Well, severe continuity problem. So you cannot just come on like gangbusters to the world. And the world says, I want a really great guru because I really want to succeed, you know. You cannot do it that way. You cannot do it that way. What they want is some super definition so they can define themselves in contrast to that, you know. Okay, I'm not that. I'm greater than that. See, I'm not that. There's a definition, and I'm not that. I'm other than that. So, mother, father, sister, brother, what a joke, there is no other. Mother, father, sister, brother, what a joke, there is no other. And you just don't define yourself. No, I'm just here now for a little while. Just here for a little while. Just being useful for a little while, that's all. Just being useful for a little while. So we think we'll insult reality by saying, hey, can you be useful for a little while? But reality understands this continuity problem. So I say, let me be useful for a little while. So don't try to heal anything. Just say, well, let this back off for a little while. Just, why not back off this a little bit for a little while? Just back off this for a little while. That won't hurt. Just kind of so you can reassess the situation. And then if you want it back, then sure, let it come back. So if someone comes to you and says, I'm going to leave. Well, sure, absolutely leave. Whoever comes is welcome. Whoever goes is welcome to go. Yeah, I don't care. There's no preference. Besides, all I'm saying is just try this out. Try Buddha Mind for a little while. Just give it a little test drive is all. That's all we're looking at. Give it a test drive. And other, spiritual ambitious will say, no. I'm here to be a great guru. I mean, I want to be enlightened. I want to get up on the stage of the world, say, hey, everybody, I'm enlightened. I'm here to heal the world. Come on. I don't want some teacher to say, well, take it for a test drive. If you don't like it, that's fine. We like it or like it. That's, either way, it's perfectly fine with me. I said, no, we need someone who's stronger than that. We need a, powerful presence here to fix the problems of the world. There are no problems. What problems? I don't see any problems. Well, how can you help us then? I mean, we're very driven to, fix the problems. We got problems here. And we need to inspire us. You're not inspiring us to fix the problems of the world, is it? It's okay. It's fine. If you don't find anything here, go somewhere else. I'm perfectly okay with that. Say, you need to be more silent. Can't you be more silent like Ramon Maharshi? You can't be real super silent because I want a super guru, because I want to be a super disciple, and I want to be super successful. So, I can't always, I'm not able to always accommodate everybody's requests for some reason. I don't know why, but, just for a little while, I'm just going to be this way, the way I am. Give it a little test drive if you want. If not, don't, then don't. It's all the same. Doesn't matter. So what are people learning then? What are they getting? Diplomacy. Spiritual diplomacy. That's really more important than anything. That's what I got from Anonymous. Because I was in need of it, drastically in need of it. the world is incredibly frightened. Our minds incredibly frightened. We're incredibly confused. We think that this false witness that the light is presenting is us. And so, if there's nothing to witness to, in other words, form, play of conflict, more and less, we think we will cease to exist. There'll be nothing for us. So we're misidentified with this false witness. And in recognizing that we're misidentified with it, then we see, oh my gosh, this whole dream, the entire thing was just a fraud by light. So it's nothing. It's not real. And then you think, well, you know, I have to drop all of it. How do I function? What's there for me? I mean, it's frightening. It's frightening. Very frightening. So even if you know the answer and you've disidentified and you know your true identity and everything, you cannot just say, hey, everybody, wake up. I got the answer. Here's the answer for you. Wake up. I'm so great. You shouldn't have any trouble with that. It doesn't work that way. It doesn't work that way. And the question is, well, then how do you find a teacher, you know, if they're not even saying that they're a teacher? That's a question, isn't it? Yeah. It's just, you know, grace somehow. Somehow you find that. If someone says, well, are you a teacher? Well, who wants to know? What wants to know? Well, it's the continuity of fear that wants to know, actually. So instead of asking questions, are you this, asking questions, instead of that, repent. Which means, say, I have a severe continuity fear. It changes everything. Completely changes the entire outlook. Because you know what your problem is. So you don't have to ask, are you a teacher or not? You say, look, I got a severe continuity problem. I need to melt this away, evaporate it gradually. Can you give me any pointers on that? Or how do I get pointers on that? And you either get pointers or you don't. So you realize you're the one with the problem. You got a severe problem. You got to focus and work on it. You're going to be working on it whether someone's a teacher or not. And ultimately, the Holy Spirit is within everyone. That's the ultimate teacher, really. So they may ask, well, does this work? Can I actually melt it all away? And you say, well, you know, they ask, you know, are you free? And I say, well. We'll just be free for a little while here. In a little way, we'll just sort of, you know, just see, just test drive it out a little bit here. I'm not saying I'm free or I'm not free. I'm just test driving a little bit here. around the world is going about building up this big production, thinking that if it just produces enough media and support, there will be some ultra guru who will come upon the world stage and say, okay, everybody, now you can all hear my voice and see my presence. Broadcast throughout the entire world, 24/7. I am here now to tell you the truth. You are free. Be free now. Everyone's working on that, actually. They're working for this. But that's not how truth works here. You'll get the Antichrist doing that. That only drives you deeper into your continuity fear. As I've said about cults, that you get pushed or forced into some sort of artificial condition you're uncomfortable, unfamiliar with, and then you're so afraid of that, they say, oh, never again, never again. In other words, the continuity issue, fear is you try to bypass this through force, spiritual charisma, shakti, all this stuff. You get so frightened of the experience, whatever you experience, that you say, never again, never again, never again. And then the one that forced you, them and their cohorts, which is a cult, usually is a charismatic cult leader with some top lieutenants who know how to do this, you know, forcing thing on you, you become terrified of them. And then they blackmail you, say, hey, look, we know you, you understand that you're not ready because you're not quite spiritually ripe enough. But we didn't realize that, or we thought you were ripe enough. You know, in other words, they blame it on you. You know, we thought you were ripe enough. Of course, you're part of the whole dance too, because you are afraid. You think you're going to outsmart the continuity thing, outsmart God. And then they say, look, we don't want to do this, you know, but it might happen again. I don't know, you know, because it's just the way you are, you know. And you say, well, what do I need to do so it doesn't happen again? I don't want this to happen again. Because they say, well, you kind of, you know, well, you need to do this for us and this for us, and you can be useful, and maybe it won't happen again if you really, really work hard on this stuff. In other words, give all your time, effort, money, worship to these lieutenants and their charismatic front man, like a band. The band has a front man, okay. But it's lieutenants who are driving the situation oftentimes, actually. Writing the songs, you know, they use the front man. They're using the front man. So the lieutenants are very much part of the situation. And so you feel like it's blackmailed by this. You feel blackmailed. So if there is to be some charismatic figure in the world with all their lieutenants there pushing on the world, this enlightenment, you know, the world's going to freak out. And then they're going to say, hey, you know, I mean, you're ready for this. It's just that something wasn't quite right here. You need to, you know, make the message strong, a little stronger, you know, and we don't want it. And people will say, okay, don't let it get in. What do I need to do? What do I need to do? So the whole world would be plunged into worshiping and under blackmail, under the threat of blackmail. We're really going to the point where this blackmail will descend upon the planet. It will descend upon the planet very badly. See, Ramana Maharshi just sat in one place, silent. Did a tremendous amount of help for all of us. Go to see him. Not going to pressure you. Who are you? Why'd you come here? What's your question? Just silent. People say, just sit down here. Can I come in? Sure, there's a place over here. You sit here. Just be quiet. Okay, you come in. And just be quiet. And what happens? Gratitude. Oh, I say, thank you so much for not trying to pressure me and blackmail me. Because I'm very vulnerable, actually. We're all very vulnerable to this pressuring. And we're doubly vulnerable because we think that this is actually going to help us. So we encourage these charismatic front people with their lieutenants, Lieutenant S's, as often the case, actually. And don't expect this powerful front person to be a man. It's probably going to be a woman, actually. This is what I've been shown. And the Lieutenant S's will be women. They'll be mostly women. There'll be a few men to kind of make it seem like it's on the up and up. And it will be this huge push saying, if you love me, then you need to really free yourself now. And so people will make this desperate effort, and what happens? They'll think they've done it, and then the backlash of the continuity fear will come ripping back like a riptide, like a tsunami. And they'll say, oh my God, this is too much, I can't handle it. And then they'll turn to this charismatic figure in our lieutenants, Lieutenant S's, and they say, help, 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 I was free, I thought I got free, but now there's, and they'll say, oh yeah, that's the evil, you know, from those people over there, the evil patriarchy or something like that, right? They've set it all up. Well, that's just the vestiges of the evil patriarchy. You're freeing yourself from the karma of that. And you're so afraid of, well, what do we need to do? What do we need to do? So, okay, well, just serve me. I'll tell you how to serve me properly and do the right things. Blackmail. Blackmail. It's all set up for blackmail, actually, in this world. Wow. Whew. Really seeing it now. So then you have this projection. You say, oh. You know, and you miss the continuity situation entirely. You say, oh, I would have been free. It's just this is the residual of the terrible patriarchy that was oppressing us all. So how do we get free of this front goddess and the lieutenantesses? And, oh, okay, well, no problem. We'll show you how. You have to worship us. You have to do this thing right. You have to do this. Give your time and attention and money to us. And we just put this full effort on. We're going to free ourselves entirely from this horrible patriarchy that caused you to not be free. You felt the freedom, didn't you? Well, see, they completely do not talk about the continuity problem at all. And this enslaves you. You will be enslaved to a cult. What's happening in the world is a world cult is forming. It's not just a little cult. It's a planetary, a global cult is forming. And they're going to try to get everybody into that global cult, because you know cults can't stand for anyone to not be in them, because they feel that's the enemy. Of course they need an enemy, don't they? If they get everyone in the cult, where's the enemy? Well, they figure that out. They say, well, it was just all the patriarchal past, you know, all the religious authorities and organizations, those have all oppressed you, that's why you're feeling the way that you are. Yeah, not true. Not at all true. And it doesn't solve anything. It's blackmail. Wow. So I've been speaking out on some of the latest videos. I've been speaking out on the matriarchy, the divine feminine, all this stuff. Why? People say, why? Because I'm getting to this bigger picture here of how the cults form. And this is a global cult that is forming. And you got to understand, this is coming from our continuity fear. It's our continuity fear that's driving this whole thing, that's insisting upon it. Because we have not repented. We don't know, we think it's too much for us. So we want to feel as if there's something controlling us, something to blame, something controlling us. We want to be blackmailed, but our desire to be blackmailed is going to give rise, and is giving rise, to these blackmailers, to these lieutenants and their charismatic front person. And for sure, the world will easily fall into that trap, the Antichrist trap. Absolutely. That's what they want. That's what they think they want. Because, as Jesus says, and the great prophets and all say, repent. You need to repent. That's this absolute essential to free yourself, quote unquote, from Satan, from this cult. This global cult. It's happened many places. It's happening here now. The whole thing is set up for a global cult. I say by 2016, July of 2016, I feel that this cult is going to sink its teeth into us. And you know, you'll either be a cult member or you won't. And you better have repented by that time. So my call is a call to repentance. A couple of years here. Call to repentance. Am I a teacher or not? I'm simply a call to repentance is all I am. Okay. For a couple of years. Then we'll see how it goes. Once you have accepted that the real problem is your continuity problem, which is actually honoring yourself, because it means you are super creative, super adventurous, fearless, intrepid. You know, you tried so hard to change reality that it resulted in a severe continuity problem. So you're honoring yourself, and by doing that, you're honoring God. You see, so God loves it when you repent. God loves it. God says, fantastic. Don't think God will be mad. Just the opposite. God says, fantastic. You finally realize just how great you truly are. You're so great that you caused yourself a tremendous continuity problem. That's so. When you repent, you're on the same page with God. And you realize, wow, I don't need to be blackmailed by this global cult. I don't need to be blackmailed by this global cult. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Of course, the global cult may say, stay here, we need someone to blame, we need someone to symbolize the evil patriarchy, you must stay here. And you say, no, I'm going to ascend to the death-free realms, along with others who have repented. And that means your cult's going to fall apart, isn't it? Well, that's great. We'll just ascend for a little while, though. Okay, let's say that. No, we're not permanently leaving you. We'll ascend for a little while, and then we'll see how it goes. And that is true. I'm not going to commit to a permanent ascension. No, nobody has to commit to a permanent ascension here. And we can say, no, I'm just not joining your cult for now. Okay. We'll revisit this, and maybe we'll revisit this in a couple years. So we need to be smart about the situation here. I mean, you can talk about whatever you want to talk about, teachers and gurus and enlightened ones, etc. We still have to be smart about the situation that is here, taking place on this planet right now. Christianity does a good job of that in some regards, because Christians are alerted, at least, there is some really heavy situation brewing on this planet. That is a fact. And you need to be super diplomatic about it and super smart about it. Now, the Christians are not smart enough about it at this stage, you know. They're still very combative. They're still very non-diplomatic about it. So they need to increase their diplomacy. And others who think that, no, everything's fine, don't worry, they need to get clued in to what's going on and increase their diplomacy also. You know, we all need to be very, very much, everyone has to repent and be very smart and very diplomatic about it. So I'm here to help with that, whatever that's for, whatever good that's for. That's how I see what I'm doing. So, of course, I may not sound like what people expect. Say, oh, how come you're saying something about this, you know, divine feminine, all this, how this is working out and stuff. It's very important to realize how the cult is going to function, how it's going to try to blackmail us, okay, and see ahead of time, oh, we see what you're doing. And it's very clever, very tricky, but we've repented and realized our problem is the continuity problem. Yeah, I don't have any other problem. Yeah, so I'm going to stick with that for a little while. So, I'm not going to join your cult yet. You know, maybe later. We'll see. Maybe later. We'll see. And, of course, you might be saying, well, that's not traditional non-dual talk. Like, who am I? I'm not. Who am I? Who am I? Who am I? And all this kind of stuff. Well, we can do that, too. But this also is super important to understand. By you're not recognizing your continuity fear. Because you think you're going to be greater than God, and you don't have to. You'll just decree it away. You don't decree it away. Not like that. You don't decree it away by saying it doesn't exist. That's the one problem that does exist. It's true that no other problems exist, but the continuity fear problem does exist. And if you get caught up in this decreeing, you're going to fall into the cult. Decreeing has to be done within the mood of repentance. Okay, or it's not going to work for you. And it's obviously not working. It's leading right into the jaws of this cult, this world cult. And you can see the whole thing brewing. I mean, for me, I've seen it my whole life, how it's brewing and brewing and brewing and brewing and brewing. And it will seem like the new world religion will seem incredibly slick. Incredibly slick. I think there's going to be a woman that is the head of it, absolutely. Most of the lieutenants will be women. And they will set everything up. We've got a new world religion, all these different degrees of teaching here, and you got to go there. So it'll seem, you know, like this is the answer. This is the answer for sure. But the new world religion will not unfold until there's this big push that frightens people. Everyone says, oh my gosh, God is here, or the goddess is here. She expects us to be enlightened. She expects us to know how to function with her, and we don't know. And so we'll really try, and then, you know, people make this huge effort, and that actually can put you into a formlessness for a moment, or in touch with the Buddha mind, in touch with your true nature, because you feel, I need to relate to God. But you're not ready to sustain it. And so the continuity fear backlash will happen to you, and then you'll feel freaked out and terrified. I don't want to happen again. So please, Goddess, tell us how to give us steps towards you, and then she'll roll out this whole new world religion of all these steps to her. And the whole thing will seem so fantastic, but it's not. It's a cult. The real teacher is the Holy Spirit. Real teacher is already with us, the Holy Spirit. We have to, and we have a severe, severe continuity problem. Now the Goddess will say, no, I'm here. I'm lifting that off of you. No, it doesn't work that way. It's the Holy Spirit that gradually and gently helps melt it away. Okay. We've already seen how this is going to work with Dafri John, who is controlled by the divine feminine, the Shakti, the feminine, so-called feminine, who's controlled by this Antichrist, in my opinion, who did a trial run with the world, did a trial run here, and to see how to, and then to iron out some of the problems that arose, etc. Okay, but the whole blackmailing thing was there. The whole cult thing was there. But I was using a man as a scapegoat, you know, setting up the next step, which was going to be a woman, actually. It's very interesting. But very compelling, you know, very compelling. It seems like everything is there. Everything is there. And they'll say, well, I'll take care of the continuity problem for you. And then you have to ask the Holy Spirit, is that true or not? So, again, the Holy Spirit is the true teacher, period. Period. If it says, hey, stay away from that teacher, stay away. Holy Spirit told me stay away from Dafri John. I stayed away. I'd actually been reading this books. My dad got a book, Need of Listening. I read that and I said, huh, interesting. And then I read some other books and I said, wow, this is amazing. I mean, this is like, you know, some really intense situation. And then I was going up to see him in the mountain sanctuary, Mountain of Attention sanctuary or something. And the car broke down, radiator blew. Bad radiator. Kaboom. I said, whoa. And I eventually hitched a ride up there and then came back with the Holy Spirit. Said, stay away, stay away, stay away, stay away, stay away. I stayed then. From that on, I stayed away. I said, something's not right. Something's not right here. So the Holy Spirit was right. The Holy Spirit was right about that. So the Holy Spirit will tell you, stay away. And you may feel, well, this is it. Here's the Goddess. And she'll say, this is the new golden age. The Goddess is here. The Goddess is the Holy Spirit principle, here to heal you. And we'll try to co-opt the Holy Spirit and say that she is the Holy Spirit. It's not true. It's not true. She says, I am the patience here. I will be patient with you. Not true. So we need to keep outing this cult ahead of time. Keep outing this cult. It's blackmail that's going to happen. Holy Spirit's formless. Holy Spirit doesn't have any male, female, it's not mother, father, sister, brother, what a joke, there is no other. Okay, mother, father, sister, brother, what a joke, there is no other. There's There's no question that the world will succumb to this to a large extent. Most. Remember, Jesus said that the trickery of the end times, the deceit of the end times will be so great that even the elect, the saints of God, will fall for it, or will certainly be tempted to fall for it. This is true. This is very true. Okay. This is not a joke. This is not a joke. This is so true. So true. And I count myself among those who still feel some vulnerability to that, no question. I have to work 24/7 on it here. Of course, because as Emma Curtis Hopkins tried to say, is the Holy Spirit, the reason why we call it the Mother Principle, because it's so patient. So the women know how, they're more patient than men, so they'll be able to solve the continuity problem for you, etc. That's the line of reasoning that they're using, you see. Now, it's not true, but how to clarify this? How to clarify this? Women are not actually as patient as they claim to be. They're actually have extreme spiritual ambition. They're patient in trying to get you over their viewpoint, but that doesn't mean they have the right viewpoint, you see. And actually, they're extremely tricky. Mothers are extremely tricky. When their patience runs thin, as it does, then they start using this blackmail on you. And then they mix it in with the patience. So it's this very tricky mixture, actually, that's used. Women are not as advertised at all. Not as advertised. They do a great job advertising how wonderful they are. It's not true. It's not true at all. They're extremely spiritually ambitious, have severe continuity problems, and are just very good at glossing it over, you know, pretending, glossing it over. But the pressure that's going to be brought to bear in this world is just, it still causes me, you know, terrified of it. It's worse than Daffrey John's whole scam, you know, worse, way worse. That was bad enough. That was insanely bad. Incredible pressure was put on so many people, and so many people crumbled under it, understandably. I don't have any, you know, tongue lashing to give to anyone to crumble, because it was only a supreme effort and help that I got that I didn't crumble. None of my ma helped out. Jesus helped out. Holy Spirit helped out. Ramana Maharshi helped out. But for sure. So just think, those who crumbled, what's coming in the future is way even more intense than that. Even more intense scam than that. The light is really upping the level of its scam here. And it's really about this witness, this false witness. And see, this cult wants the attention on the forms here. Divine feminine, the form of that, form. They don't want you to shift your attention to formlessness. Formlessness, absolutely not. And so they leave out that part of the false witness, having their attention shift to true formlessness. Daffy John always say, no, put your attention on my form. My form is God. Put my attention on my form. That's where you get the grace. My form. You know, he was, you know, fanatical about that. Absolutely fanatical. That's the goddess. That's actually was the goddess speaking through him. A feminine principle speaking through him, the Shakti. He claimed the Hollywood Temple that he overcame the Shakti. That was a lie. That was the Shakti lying. He was overpowered by the Shakti at the Hollywood Vedanta temple. And then the Shakti started speaking through him. And of course, the first thing the Shakti did was lie and say that he had overcome the Shakti. So everybody thought, oh, okay, this isn't the Shakti. He overcame the Shakti. No, he did not. The Shakti overpowered him. And the Shakti lied about it in order to use him. It was the Shakti that was running everything. It was the feminine principle, the Shakti that was running everything, the whole scam. Shakti said, it's incredible. This great teacher has overpowered the Shakti and overcome the Shakti. And now you can completely trust him because this is God. This is the sign of God. He's overcome the Shakti. It was the Shakti speaking the whole time that had overcome him and was now misleading everybody. So, yes, even the elect of God will be deceived or very sorely tempted. Paradoxically, it's the ones that are downplaying their significance that are the most helpful. Because there's the contrast, right? You don't fight fire with fire. It's the Nanda Maya Ma, her spiritual diplomacy, that won me over. I said, hey, you know, this is better. This is someone who knows better than Dafri John, superior. Of course, he said he was the most superior of all. I'll never mention Nanda Maya Ma because he couldn't. Because people would say, okay, let's contrast the two. So he left her out entirely. Very telling. And the whole basket of tolerance thing, naming all these teachers in history that he was greater than, he left her out. An extreme omission, okay. Now maybe a couple years ago or something, they maybe tried to shoehorn her in or something, but throughout the whole time he was here, left her out. And I said, why are you leaving her out? Huh, you say you know every great teacher's ever been here in history, you're God, and you leave out Ananda Maya Ma, are you kidding me? And of course, she is totally spiritual diploma. I'm nobody. I'm just a stupid little girl. I don't know anything. And so I said, hey, you know, obviously you do know. You're incredible, but you're just downplaying, completely downplaying it. And I said, I like this. I feel some true support, you know, a true feeling like, wow, this is really something, actually. It's not some blackmail, it's not some force, it's not some demands, you know, it's just everything's perfect. I'm just here to reassure you of that, that's all. I said, wow. So, it's paradoxical. You don't fight fire with fire. You don't say, when this blackmailing cult comes in, you don't say, hey, I'm here as I'm the one who's better, you know. Just you have to be very relaxed, very calm. Downplay your presence. Don't be boastful. Don't say, hey, everybody, I've got the answer. Everyone, you have to come see me. I got the answer. I can just let the presence speak for itself. And somehow God will enable you to find out about this. The grace of God will somehow enable you to find out about this. And you'll say, hey, wait a minute. Maybe something's not quite right with this global cult, actually. It seems so wonderful, but I'm not so really sure about it, actually. Dafri John did an incredible job bamboobalizing. The Shakti did a great job bamboobalizing so many. Wow. That was like a full-on sorority rush type of thing. You gotta sign up. Don't miss it. This is the last teacher there ever will be. You gotta sign up. If you miss this, you'll miss it forever. Yeah. Heavy stuff there. And of course, it stampeded a lot of people. And maybe they're wondering, like, wow, how can I forgive myself? Well, you have to accept responsibility. You have to repent is how you do it. You say, I got a severe continuity problem, really severe. It's the only problem I have. I don't have any other problem. but I do have a very severe continuity problem, and I need to get serious about that. I need a real teacher, you know. I need real teaching. Not really great fake teaching, a really great fake teacher, but the, you know, the reality. My problem is so severe, I need actually the truth. Okay, gradually, I need the Holy Spirit. I need the Holy Spirit. Repent. I need the Holy Spirit. King of Heaven is at hand. Repent. Accept the Holy Spirit as your teacher. Make sure your primary teacher is formless. Okay? Make sure your primary teacher is formless. Forever formless. Not someone saying, well, I am just the appearance of the formlessness. No. Okay. That's the trap. That's the trap. Accept the Holy Spirit, which is forever formless. So here we go, here we go. We're almost in July, right? And this is when we really prepare. We have 2 years to prepare, 2 years to prepare. Now the light, of course, is busy. The light that's in the producing this scam for us is busy trying to produce the counter. The counter to this one world religion goddess is present in the world situation. This cult, this goddess cult, actually, is busy orchestrating the opposition to that. But that too is part of the scam. It's orchestrating false opposition, opposition that will crumble. You see, how can you believe, how will the world believe that this goddess is really God here, the goddess is with us, and this is true, and this is the one where religion is all true, unless she has some opposition that she can overcome and it will crumble, and people say, ah, it really is, this is, the divine is with us now. So, the light is orchestrating this false, this opposition that is weak and vulnerable, that will crumble. It's doing that for sure. For sure. The Holy Spirit has tipped me off to that. And say, don't you be part of that false opposition. Because the false opposition will get a lot of play too. It will seem like, hey, you know, they'll be very famous, get a lot of airplay, a lot of attention, a lot of attention. But they're just a patsy who are being set up for this goddess cult to crush them. And everyone will say, oh, you must be divine then, because you've crushed this opposition and proven that they couldn't stand up to you. So that's all part of the setup. That's all part of the setup. This is wicked stuff, isn't it? But again, we asked for it. We told light to deceive us. So it goes all in on this. It goes all in on this. We just thank it. Say thank you, light, for setting up this total blackmail, deception, false oppositional paradigm matrix here. Wonderful job. Love it. Love you. Love it. Thank you so much. I very much appreciate it. And now I'm going to shift the attention of the false witness onto the vision of oneness, equal presence of light everywhere. That's what I'm going to do. That's what I'm asking you, requesting of you now. So do not fight against it. You see what I'm saying? Love it. Appreciate it. Thank you very much. Be aware of it. Be aware of it. Say, this is what it is. Thank you very much. I appreciate it 100%. Wonderful. Great job. I see you're really still on the ball here, light. And now I request of you that I solve the continuity problem. Be resolved for me. False witness, attention on a vision of oneness. Equal presence of light. That's it. So do not be part of the heavy opposition. That's a trap. That's part of the trick. Just be blissful. Everything's perfect. You can be that way when you see through the scam, right? Don't take sides. Don't neither one. Don't get caught up in either one. Just say, say thank you, light, for honoring my request. That you did your great job. And now I have another request of you that the continuity problem get resolved. And then people will see that and they'll say, hey, Maybe there is some other way. I feel trapped here. Something isn't right. Something doesn't add up here. My intuition is telling me something doesn't add up here. And then you can, you know, say, here, this is how you really deal with the continuity problem, okay? This is how it's dealt with the right way. It's just not evil. Thank the light for its scam. Don't be part of this false opposition. Don't be part of the goddess cult. Neither one. Thank the light for its service. This is just a light. This is just a play of light. Thank the light for its service. Thank the light for its perfect responsiveness. Thank you, light, for being so perfectly responsive. Perfect job. Thank you very much. Now I have another request for you. Like that. Just like that. That's not too difficult. That's not too difficult. We can do that. Absolutely, we can do that. Because you have to honor yourself in order to honor God. When you honor God, you realize you're on the same page of God, and you can trust God. You're no longer afraid of God. You can trust the Holy Spirit. You can trust the vision of oneness. You can trust it. Equal presence of light everywhere. All is one being. No greater, no lesser. It's impossible. All is one universal being. Okay, just one being. That's it. And you can trust that. Because you realize you're not afraid of God anymore. You've honored God by honoring yourself, your own request that the light do this. By saying I have a severe continuity problem, you're honoring yourself, honoring God. God honors you back. God honors you back. God honors you back. It says here's the Holy Spirit. Here's the vision of oneness. Get rid of your dream. Just see equal the presence of light everywhere. I want to honor what you've done. I'm honoring it, okay? So it's an equal presence everywhere. You're not condemning anyone. You're aware, certainly, of the trickeration of the light. But again, you've forgiven everything. All is forgiven. Equal presence of light is there. Bliss is, presence of bliss is here. Absolute stillness is here. Just let it be here. That's all that's necessary. And recruiters will come say, come on, you need to be recruited. They'll either recruit you into the cult of the goddess or the cult of the opposition to the goddess. One of the two. Don't be recruited into either one. Just say, thanks. Great job. Great job pushing the recruitment. I really appreciate it. And not now. Not now, but thanks. Thanks, Light, for honoring my request to, you know, even though it was a crazy request, I see you're still honoring it perfectly. That's great. Maybe later. Maybe we'll revisit the request later as possible. Of course, they'll say, well, later's too late. You know, you have to do it now. This is, you know, say, well, that's wonderful. Thank you for the urgency. I really appreciate the urgency. But I'm not going, I don't have a response to that urgency at this time. And we'll see later if, you know, how it works out. Well, you're going to be doomed. You're going to be doomed. You say, well, I appreciate your pointing out the threateningness. I appreciate the threatening message that you have for me, but I'm not going to entertain it at this point. Maybe a little later. Perhaps I'll change my mind later. Say, later I'll be too late. Well, thanks for telling me that I'll be too late, etc., but I'm not going to entertain that. I appreciate it very much. I'm not going to entertain that message at this time, maybe a little later. How can the light be late? How can the light be late? It'll be too late. Too late for what? Too late for the light? Really? But you say, well, you know, perhaps you can issue a warning later, if you would like to. Maybe I'll issue another warning then, or, you know, you can revisit me at some point. It's always possible. I'm not closing any door, but just not right now. Just not right now. Okay, so we'll work on this. It's very important, actually. You do not want to get caught up on this dualistic, this spiritual duality of what God is called and the opposition of what God is called, and this fight and conflict, and then the triumph of one or the other, then the triumph supposedly proving that the one that triumphs must be true. You know, you don't want to get caught up in that. It's very seductive, and you will regret being caught up in it, like those who got caught up in Doffrey John's scam. How many regretted that very severely, actually. Profound regrets, actually. Do not want to get caught up in this. So just listen and hear. If you get reactive to what I say, just say, wait, well, that's not my problem. What he said is not my problem. My problem is the continuity problem. Stick with that. No matter what happens, say, my only problem that I have is the continuity problem. Don't have any other problem, and the vision of oneness is the cure for the continuity problem. It's the only cure there is for it. Just stick with that. So I don't have a problem with what he said. I have a continuity problem. The problem with what he said has no value whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value. Only the vision of oneness solves my continuity problem. And you just stay centered that way, no matter what anybody says. You just stay centered that way. Okay, this has been an incredible video, because I had not put this together. I hadn't seen the opposition as fake also, and that's part of the whole trap. I hadn't seen that. I hadn't seen it quite as clear as this. So this is a hugely significant video that puts the whole thing into the right context. It's just, wow, this is what's up. Okay, very great. That's it.